Hi there. You are now watching Module 10, Unit 10.2 of this Delphi series for beginners. In this lesson, we look at the different data types that can be stored with a Delphi program. The lesson follows on the previous video where we looked at data storage. Please make sure that you first watch Unit 10.1 before you continue with this lesson. I also recommend that you get a pen and a notebook out, because in this lesson you may want to write down a few notes. Pause the video to make notes, and when you are done, watch it again without any interruptions. Okay, let's start with data types in Delphi. In Unit 10.1, we learned that programmers often need to store data, sometimes in short-term memory and sometimes persisted on hard disks. With both approaches, these data types or resources that we store must be of a specific data type. But what is a data type? And how do we choose the correct data type? A data type is the kind of data that you want to store. To choose the correct data type, you must ask yourself the following questions. Is the value to be stored a number? And if it is it a whole number or is it a decimal number? How big or small will the number be? In other words, what is the range? It is also important to know if you must store negative numbers. Will the value that you want to store be a date, like a birthday, or is it a character string? In other words, a letter, a word, or a phrase. Or do you want to save a bit value or a boolean like true or false? Now, let's assume you want to store a number, like someone's age or the distance between two cities. Let's explore numbers. The smallest numeric data type is called a byte. When you reserve space in storage for a byte, you are telling Delphi to reserve exactly one byte. Numbers stored in bytes must be whole numbers. They must be positive, in other words, equal or greater than zero, and they cannot exceed 255. Bytes are also called 8-bit integers, because one byte in computers has a combination of 8 ones and zeros in binary. Bytes are the smallest integer type. The age of a human being is an ideal number to store in a byte. Humans are never younger than zero, and I do not know anyone older than 255. When we reserve space, we must tell the compiler that we want to name that space in storage, because we sometimes need to reference it many times in our code. These names have the same rules and conventions as the visual components you explored in previous lessons. Programmers use descriptive names to make it easier for them to reference it in code. If you are not familiar with naming rules and conventions in Delphi, please watch Unit 7.1, which covers naming rules and conventions. We use a prefix for our names. The prefix used indicates what data type we want to declare. For a byte, we use the three-letter prefix BTE. However, I've seen many programmers and programming teams that only use a single-letter prefix like B for the byte data type. I prefer to use the three-letter prefix because if we use B, it may become confusing because a Boolean data type that we will look at later will then also use B as a prefix, and that may cause confusion. A three-letter prefix makes it more descriptive and it helps to avoid ambiguities. So, in this course, I will use BTE for a byte. You must use whatever is required by your team or what is prescribed in school or college. A suitable name for age will therefore be BTE age. Notice that this name is typed using camel case, with no spaces and special characters. This name must also be unique. The next type of whole number is a small int. A small int also holds whole numbers in data storage, just like a byte. But a small int is somewhat bigger. It can also hold numbers smaller than zero, in other words, negative numbers. The lowest number that goes into a small int is -32,768. And the highest number is +32,767. A small int uses 2 bytes in storage. It is also often called a 16-bit integer, because 2 bytes in computers are 16 ones and zeros. A small int's name starts with the 3-letter prefix SML. See, here we can also use a single-letter prefix like S, but then the string data type that we will explore later will also use S as its prefix. Therefore, I prefer the three-letter prefix for more clarity. The distance between two cities may be a good candidate value to save into a small int. provided that you do not want to store distances greater than 32,767. A suitable name for that will be SML distance, or SML miles, or SML kilometers. The integer data type also stores whole numbers in data storage, just like bytes and small ints. But an integer is much bigger. It can also hold numbers smaller than 0, just like a small int. The lowest number that goes into a int is -2,147,483,648, and the highest number is +2,147,483,648. The integer data type is 4 bytes in storage. It is also often called a 32-bit integer, because 4 bytes in computers are 32 ones and zeros, or 4 sets of 8 bits each. An integer's name starts with the 3-letter prefix int. Like I said before, you may use a 1-letter prefix like I for integer, but I prefer the 3-letter prefix int. Counting the stars in the night sky will amount to a number bigger than 32,768. So a small int is not big enough. Therefore, we will declare an integer for the star count. A suitable name will therefore be int star or int star count. Delphi also provides data types for decimal numbers. They are also called floating point numbers, or just floats in short. The first type of floating point number is a single. The name refers to a single precision decimal number. What is important to understand with floating point numbers is that their precision also determines the storage size. Fractions can be stored with 7 to 8 decimal digit precision in a single. The single data type can also hold fractions smaller than 0. In other words, negative and positive numbers can be saved in a single. The single data type uses 4 bytes in storage. A single's name starts with the 3-letter prefix SNG. Again, you may use a 1-letter prefix like S for single. But what about string and small int? They also start with S. SNG fraction is therefore a suitable name for single. A value stored in a single is often the result of a division. If your calculations require single precision, in other words up to 8 decimal digits, you will declare a single. The second type of floating point number is called a double. The name refers to a double precision decimal number. Fractions can be stored with 15 or 16 decimal digit precision in a double. That is twice or double the precision of a single. Like a single, the double data type can also hold fractions smaller than 0. In other words, negative and positive numbers can be saved in a double. The double data type uses 8 bytes in storage. A double's name starts with the 3-letter prefix DBL. You may use a 1-letter prefix like D for double, but I prefer the 3-letter prefix DBL for more consistency. DBL Pi or DBL Lightspeed is therefore a suitable name for a double. A value stored in a double is also often the result of a division. If your calculations require double precision, in other words up to 16 decimal digits, you will declare a double. Some of you may be familiar with the real data type in Delphi. I see on the internet that real is now considered obsolete. The recommendation is to use a double instead. Now, let's look at the currency data type. A currency is often used to store monetary values. As you can see, we can store huge numbers in a currency. Let's say that big number. From -922,332,303,685,477.5808 to +922,332,303,685,477.5808. Wow, that is an insane pile of cash. This number can also be a minus, so that can be a massive debit or deficit. The currency data type also uses 8 bytes in storage, but unlike the other decimal data types, it stores only up to 4 decimal digits for cents. A currency's name starts with the 3-letter prefix CUR. You may use a 1-letter prefix like C for currency, but I prefer the 3-letter prefix CUR for more consistency. Because the character data type that we will explore in a moment also starts with a C. CUR payment or CUR deficit will therefore be suitable names for a currency. Now let's have a look at the character data types. We will start with char. The char data type stores a single ASCII character. I will explain ASCII later, but for now you only need to know that ASCII is one of the standards for characters in the computer industry. The char data type uses 1 byte. A char's name starts with the 3-letter prefix, CHR. Like I said, you may use a 1-letter prefix like C for char, but I will use CHR for more consistency, because we saw that currency also starts with C. CHR initial is therefore an example of a suitable name for a char. The next data type that stores characters is a string. Strings contain one or more characters, like words, phrases, sentences, or even paragraphs. These characters are also according to the standards of ASCII, and therefore 1 byte per character. My name, Gerard, will therefore use 7 bytes in storage, 1 byte per character. The string's name starts with the 3-letter prefix STR. Again, you can use S, but I prefer STR, because we saw that the single data type can also start with an S. STR phrase or STR message are therefore examples of suitable names for strings. Okay, let's now have a look at some other data types that we also often use in Delphi for storage. Let's start with the tDateTime data type. tDateTime holds a combination of a date and time. The date can go as far back as December 30th, 1899. The tDateTime data type also uses 8 bytes in storage. Because dates are expressed in different formats in different countries and cultures, we will also learn how to use date functions to format the date, or how to store and extract only the date portion or the time portion for a value used in a tDateTime. A tDateTime's name starts with the 3-letter prefix DTE, like DTE birthday. Again, the double data type also starts with D, so I do not like to use the single letter prefix D for tDateTime. The Boolean data type is used to store either true or false. This is often used to flag whether a condition changed, or to indicate if a value exists, or if a component is enabled or disabled, or visible or invisible. The Boolean data type uses 1 byte in storage. A Boolean's name starts with the 3-letter prefix BLN. Because the byte data type also starts with a B, I prefer to use BLN to avoid confusion. These data types are not the only ones available in Delphi, but they are the ones that we will use most often. These data types are generally used by other programming languages too. There may be a few differences here and there, but most programming environments do provide a way to resolve these differences. The last thing about these data types, they can be used to store values in short-term memory as variables or in data sources like databases as fields. Before we go, just a few notes. You can download the video tutorials as well as the project files of Delphi examples that I demonstrate in these videos from Patreon. Just go to patreon.com/learnDelphi and search for the module or unit. If a tutorial has downloads available, you will find the link at the bottom of the lesson. Click the link and download and extract the zip file to a location of your choice. I included a video folder and 2 project folders, a starter folder that you can use when I start a demo for that specific lesson, and the solution folder that contains a working project that you can use to compare your project with mine. A big thank you to my patrons. Your support helps me to plan my time and resources more efficiently, and encourages me to continue making awesome lessons. Even if you are not a patron yet, it will help a lot to boost my channel if you like my videos and subscribe to my channel. Also, share my videos with your friends and colleagues on social media. If you want to get notifications of new content that I publish, hit the bell icon below this video. And with that, we reach the end of this session. Our next lesson will be great fun. We will learn how to apply these data types in code with variable declarations. I hope to see you in the next lesson.